One of the topics on which I worked recently is the concept of global liquidity and its relationship with asset prices in emerging market countries. The concept of global liquidity has regained new interest among the international financial community, both institutional and academics, since the trigger of the global financial crisis in 2008. Actually, if the concept of global liquidity is commonly used, it remains difficult to define it precisely. For example, during the last financial crisis, the excess of global liquidity combined with liquidity shortfalls on financial markets fueled what we can call a liquidity paradox. This points out the multiple dimension of liquidity. Generally, the global liquidity represents the perception of agents about the availability of funds, that is the financial facility at the level of the international financial system. Actually, three dimensions must be distinguished: the monetary versus the market and funding concepts. Monetary liquidity or official liquidity comes from central banks and represents overall funding conditions in the world economy. In contrast, market and funding liquidity broadly refer to the private liquidity and come from financial and non-financial sectors through cross-border operations. For our purpose, we focus in particular on monetary liquidity. Since the global financial crisis in 2008 and 2009, central banks in advanced economies and emerging markets, but to a lesser extent, have lowered aggressively their policy rate to zero and ultimately used unconventional measures to mitigate the effects of the crisis and address disruptions in the supply of liquidity. For example, the Fed in the US has launched three quantitative easing programs to alleviate the impact of the crisis and stimulate the economy as a last resort. The QE1 was launched in November 2008, the QE2 in November 2010, and the QE3 in September 2012. In this context, the increase of global liquidity has been huge for the eight past years. It has reached historically high levels. This surge in global liquidity has resulted in a very low interest rate environment that has prompted international investors to seek higher yield, especially in emerging market countries. These strategies coming from investors promote strong capital flows from advanced countries to emerging markets that can lead to upward pressures on asset prices, both stock prices or exchange rates. It may have harmful consequences on financial stability of emerging countries that receive those flows. The implications of global liquidity on asset prices and more broadly on financial stability are quite strong. In a global environment characterized by a high degree of capital mobility and financial integration, spillover effects through capital flows concern both domestic funding conditions and domestic asset prices. What are the underlying mechanisms? During inflows episodes, emerging markets face upward pressure on financial assets, equities, bonds, exchange rates, but also on real estate prices coming from international investors searching for higher yield. Those pressures push prices up, sometimes well above fundamental values. Besides, those inflows bring lower funding costs that encourage the private sector in emerging markets to increase its debt leverage, fueling balance sheet mismatches, both in terms of debt to equity ratio and in terms of maturity and currency mismatch. In case of sudden stops of capital flows or sudden withdrawals, emerging countries are exposed to a sharp depreciation of their currency, but also to a sudden hike of funding costs that may be very harmful with a high risk of economic contractions. Consequences have been so damaging for the emerging countries that some of them have decided to impose capital controls to limit the volatility of capital flows. research focuses on the impact of global liquidity on asset prices in emerging markets by introducing non-linearity into our empirical methodologies. In fact, there are several reasons to believe that asset prices in emerging markets react differently to a rise in global liquidity, due to the fact that the usual channel of monetary policy transmission may have been impaired during the crisis, or because of the position of economies in the different phases of the business cycle. Along with the impact of global liquidity, we consider also the shift in international investor sentiment, as investors' risk appetite seems to be a key determinant of capital flows and financial contagion. Our principal result is that relationship between global liquidity and equity prices appears to be non-linear. In fact, global liquidity contributes to the rise of stock prices only when global risk aversion is low. On the contrary, during periods of financial stress, the impact of global liquidity becomes negative. Our research contributes to the recent debate on the cross-border impact of monetary policies defined by major central banks. Our result could then justify the need for better coordination at global level. It also raises the question of the role of capital controls and macroprudential measures to mitigate financial instability.